control system. This is our steady state and step response for our system. And the other members of my team are Emily Montalve, Jacqueline Walker, Jacqueline Rich, and Rachel, who's not here today. And in the introduction, I'm going to explain the voltage system background, and in that system background, I'm going to describe it. I'm going to show you the SSOC and the step response. And then I'm going to talk about the FOPDT theory, and the model theory, and the results for our system. This is what our system looks like. You can see the motor and generator, and it leads to the light bulbs, which show you the output. And then this is a block diagram for our system. On the left, manipulative variable, and the input is in power percent, and then it is the voltage system, and then the output is a control variable, and it's in volts. And then this is a schematic for our system. It has a motor, a generator, a transmitter, a computer, and you tell the computer what you want the power input to be, and it transmits that to the motor generator, and then it shows it in the light bulb. This is one of our SSOC trials for the voltage versus time at 74% input. And you can see that the output is about 50 to 53 volts at that input. And then this is our SSOC. And our SSOC has linear regions, but it's also it varies a lot. This is the upper range for our system, and it's in this range it's linear, and it's from 75 to 85 volts, and in this range the slope of it is 2 volts per percent input. And then this is the mid range, and it's 70 to 75 volts, and the slope of this region is 8.4 volts per percent input. And then this is just the lower range. And it's from 0 to 25, and it has a slope of 0 volts per percent input. And this is just a sample of our step input for our voltage system. The input was 78. The input was 79, and then it was stepped up to 77, and then it gave 79%, and then it jumped to 75 volts. And this is the gain for our system. And it was calculated to be 1.93 volts per percent input. This is the dead time. And it was, we have very little dead time in our system, and it's 0.034 seconds. And this is the time constant tau. And we calculated it to be 0.306 seconds for this step response. And this is the results when you compare all of our data. And some of them we have a lot of uncertainty, and then others there's hardly any. We're not really sure exactly why we have so much uncertainty in some, and it's not in the others. And again, this is the dead time. And some of them we have a lot of response, but a lot of uncertainty, but most of them are pretty well. We don't have very much uncertainty in those. And this is the time constant tau. And then in the FOPDT model, these are the parameters that I made whenever I just did an example one. And I said that the TD was 2%, the A was 3%, and the K was 4% per volt. The time was 5 seconds, and the tau was 6 seconds, and then the input was 0 volts in the output. And this is what it gave me. You can see the input and the output, and how it has the step curve. And then this was actually one of our experiment results. The input was 70%, and then I stepped it up to 77% input, and the input voltage before the step up was about 70.8 and then the output was about 58. And then this is the one when we fitted the model curve with the experimental curve. And the model input and the experimental output overlap. And so you can just barely see a little bit of point on where the external input is. But then the output, you can see how the curve fits. And this is one for the step down. And again, you can barely see the experimental input. And these were our overall results for our experiment. In the 0 to 15 volt range, the K was 0.73, and the TO was 0.15, and the tau was 3.78. In the 15 to 30 volt range, the K was 11.6, the TO was 0.04, and the tau was 31.23. We don't know why that one was so much higher than all the other ones. And then in 30 to 45 range, the K was 10.86, the TO was 0.05, and the tau was 5.98. In the 45 to 60 range, the K was 4.42, the TO was 0.05, and the tau was 0.32. In the 60 to 75 range, it was 1.92, the TO was 0.03, and the tau was 0.32. And these were all very close to what we calculated for the model to. And these are for the decreasing step results. And you can see that the experimental is similar to the model. The increasing and decreasing steps values vary some, but they're pretty low. They're steady. Well, they're not steady, but they're similar. And in conclusion, this SOC showed the relationship between the power input and the voltage output. And in our SSOC, we had a upper, middle, and lower range, and these ranges do not share the same behavior. The step response shows up and down that are similar towards the regions, but are differ in the middle range region. And then these were our averages for the K when we compared them to the step up and step down. And we found the average K to be 0.35 volts per percent input, the TO to be 0.085 seconds, the tau to be 0.68 seconds. And then for the model average K, we found it to be 30.28 volts per percent input, the model TO to be 0.096 seconds, and the model tau to be